Okay. Here we go with a good game to start our week. Between Hive Mind and Team Priapism, both teams in the playoff field. Hive Mind are 3-4 in seventh. Priapism ahead of them by virtue of having played one less game at 3-3 in sixth. Hive Mind have 10 points per game and Priapism have 9. Thing to watch, Hive Mind are second in own niche percentage, which is no surprise. Maybe the only surprise of the stat is that they're behind Don't Blow It for first in own niche percentage. Priapism currently have the best points per game of any season they've had. So, I mean, they made a final, but now they're doing even better than that. So it's been a good season so far. If you're a Priapism fan, of which there are dozens of us. Dozens. Great meme. Okay. Dozens is actually probably generous. Last week, Sandusky's won 13 to 10. Excuse me, Hive Mind beat Sandusky's 13 to 10, and Priapism won their last game against Franchester United 2 weeks ago. We will start with the category that I thought I spoiled, but it turns out I hadn't. White people music. Lot of whites in this game, so does anyone want?
No double.
Right, you're getting song snippets, like 5-ish seconds of a song. No, sorry, 10-ish seconds of a song, and you have to say name the artist. Hive Mind with Austin's camera acting up per usual. Here's your
Yep.
question. For 1 point, no one doubled. Name the artist based on the song snippet. I'm gonna turn it down a little bit.
I got one guess.
I have zero guesses.
I have one guess too.
Eli, you tell me yours.
I think it's wrong. Sarah Bareilles.
I was also thinking Sarah Bareilles. I think you're right.
Unless it's like Celine Dion or something.
Well, that'd be quite the start if that's who it is and you just gave it away like that. But Eli, why don't you lock in Sarah Bareilles? We'll get another Eli game started here.
Hey, Sarah Bareilles, final.
Eli game underway. It is Sarah Bareilles with Gravity. People in the YouTube comments were very emotional over this song, let me tell you. All right, Priapism to tie it up. Here is your song. Name the artist based on the song snippet.
This is
I'm
awfully
ashamed to
defined hood
admit
classic.
that I have no idea who sings it.
Oh, I was really hoping you guys would know.
Oh, this is so embarrassing. Let me think. Oh, no.
Oh, do we need to burn a phone a friend on this one?
I. That would be a damn shame. But you have to assume they're going to steal it, so we should burn it.
Yeah, I think we do need to. We just got to pick the right person.
Two of them outed themselves.
Yeah, you can't call Footer or Fog because they commented on it. I don't think you will.
There might be someone right outside my room right now who would know.
Okay, if you're confident, then
I'm pretty confident.
okay, yeah.
1 minute.
Okay, I'm gonna phone a friend early.
Hey, pause the movie, pause the movie, pause the movie, pause the movie.
Reset hole.
Okay, Gail, you're my phone a friend. Are
Matt,
you
can we
open
get
for
our
your
point?
talk?
Of
course.
yeah, I'll
Name
go.
the artist based on the song snippet. You ready? You're the only one who can talk.
Right, here it is.
Oh, shoot.
Fuck me.
Oh, no. I like know it.
Oh my gosh.
Wait, oh shoot. I
No.
literally sing this song like every day.
Have 20 seconds.
You take the L so I can say it?
No, you can't say
No.
it.
I would even
Take the L, I'm ready. You need the
No.
artist too. I have the artist. I got
It's
the
just the artist, but no one, Gail's the only one who can talk.
Five, four, three.
Give me a name. Are you out?
No, just shut the door. You can't say. You can't say.
15 seconds, and you can come with a guess. You have 15 seconds to come with a guess.
Well, that was sorry about that, guys.
Yeah, I have no idea.
I don't know who it is. It's right on the tip of my tongue. It's not. It's like Jordan Sparks.
One.
No, it's not.
I took Jordan Sparks.
Yeah, I got to
guess. Natasha Bedingfield.
Yep.
Yep.
Yeah.
Eli, go ahead.
No, that's it.
That's annoying.
Yeah, I know. Lock it in. It's your game.
No, Gravel, lock her in.
All right, Natasha Bedingfield, final.
All right, Hive Mind with some peak Spurs ball movement there on who's going to get the final answer, which, of course, we don't even track personal stats. So that makes it 2-0. Even though Priapism didn't get it right on their phone a friend, I'm glad they called so that way we could hear it again because it's a banger for sure.
That was a thrilling phone a friend. It was like there was a bomb in the background. I didn't know if that guy was going to say anything or not.
Yeah, it was getting real spicy on whether we were going to have an issue there. Pokemon time. So make it 4-0, but Priapism can cut that in half if they get their niche. What is the name of the corporation in Gen 3 whose scientists you rescue from Team Aqua or Magma and whose president then rewards you with items such as the PokéNav and EXP share?
I'm pretty sure. I mean, what else could it be called? Well... See, I've never actually heard its name. It's run by President Stone. His son is Stephen Stone. I'm gonna go with it's the Devon Corporation. Final answer, not Stone.
Correct. Yeah, you get the Devon goods.
The Devon goods. Yeah.
Devon goods.
I was gonna say Stone, but yeah. Damn, that was a tough one.
Yeah, I thought that one through. I almost asked another Gen 4 question, and I'm like, I asked a lot of Gen 4 questions, so I just switched it up. Priapism, car brands, for your 2 points. Since the 1980s, Vauxhall's vehicles have been largely identical to what German brand that is also part of Stellantis? I didn't know how to phrase this, but it's this Vauxhall and this German brand is the same car. They just brand it differently. All their cars are the same.
I don't know.
Not Volkswagen.
I don't think so.
What other German brands are part
of Stellantis?
Or the only other one that I like, Audi, or is it just some like really fringe car?
It can't be any of those. I have no idea.
If we can't think of anything, we should just go with Volkswagen.
Yeah, I mean, is there any other German brands?
Man, it's going to be one of those games.
Dude, I literally have no idea. This doesn't. Might be Volkswagen, but I don't think it is. I'm going to say Volkswagen final.
Okay, that is incorrect.
I have no clue. I don't know.
Well, we know it can't be Audi, and it's not going to be BMW, and I don't know any other German. Eli, you don't know any random German car manufacturers?
Isn't BMW German?
Yeah, but you know it's not going to be BMW. I don't think.
I have no idea then.
Yeah, we'll have to go with BMW. Final answer.
This would be Opel. Opel.
Didn't know it was German.
Yeah, same cars, they just put a different stamp on them. Okay. Vigrants, this might be one of those teams. It's probably going to feel like that after this category. End of an era. It's a Premier League question. I used this end of an era category with NHL before. Now it's Premier League. Long way to go. Hive Mind / Priapism, I guess. Do you want a double?
No.
Okay.
We don't want a double here. Right, team? Well, consult the team.
No, we're good.
Yeah. It could be piss easy. It could be very hard.
All right, your question. I'm feeling it'll be one of the two. Who replaced Sir Alex Ferguson as Manchester United manager upon his retirement in 2013?
David Moyes, final answer. The chosen one.
Correct. David Moyes. So So that makes it 5-0. Priapism can get on the board here. Your question: who replaced Arsene Wenger as Arsenal manager upon his retirement in 2018?
Nathan Shelley.
That was such an insult to say that we could get on the board here.
That was ridiculous. There was no chance.
I believe in you guys.
Oh, Vagrant, for a second, I thought you actually knew who it was.
No, I just named a character from Ted Lasso.
I say we just go with it then.
Yeah, go with it. Final.
Nathan Shelley, final.
Spence, let me guess.
Okay, don't say final.
Is it Unai Emery?
Yes.
Final.
Nice. All right, final.
That is true.
I was shocked.
I was hoping you weren't going to say Mikel Arteta.
I was shocked Spencer didn't want to double it because there was no chance we would steal.
All right. Now, I really do think Priapism could get on the board.
I don't know it's going to be about coaches.
Conference bowl tie-ins. It's a college football category. The way this is going to work is that you're going to see four bowl games. Three of those bowl games have a contractual relationship with a single conference. One of the bowl games does not.
So
you have to name which conference goes to three of those bowl games and which bowl game does not involve that conference.
Priapism. I want a double.
God, we don't.
All right, double on the board. Can possibly make it 6-3 here very quickly.
Tough one.
Hive Mind, here is yours. One of the following bowl games involves a team from the same conference. Name the conference in the one bowl that does not involve one of their teams. The Orange Bowl, the Gator Bowl, the Alamo Bowl, and the Sun Bowl. And I just want to stress, it's not about what teams were in it this year. It's like what conferences are tied to these bowls. Obviously, you could use that as a clue.
Can
you punt it?
No. I would guess it's the SEC, right? With the names of those? And then which one do we think wouldn't be in the SEC?
Dude, I honestly...
Orange Bowl. All right, we're going to say the SEC... And the Orange Bowl is not part of it. Final answer.
Oh, wait. Is it Bygren? Is it the SEC and Alamo Bowl?
Who did Texas play in the Alamo Bowl this year?
I thought that was Alamo Bowl was like Pac-12 and
Big 12. I think you're right.
And I thought the Orange Bowl was SEC and ACC. I just don't know about the Gator and the Sun Bowl.
I think the SEC is the Gator Bowl. So let's go SEC Alamo Bowl. Final.
You got the bowl right, but it's the ACC.
Oh.
The SEC is not in the Orange Bowl. It's just the ACC.
Woof.
What's the other team that goes into the Orange Bowl?
There's only one tie, and the other one is just an at-large team.
Oh, okay.
Eli, where are you on that one?
When Spencer said SEC Orange Bowl, I thought it was right.
Yeah, because Gator Bowl is SEC. Sun Bowl is not SEC as well. Sun Bowl is ACC Pac-12.
Okay.
All right. But that was not your double. This one is. Same thing. All but one of the following bowl games involves a team from the same conference. Name the conference and the one bowl that does not involve one of their teams. The Sugar Bowl, the Holiday Bowl, the Citrus Bowl, and the Music City Bowl.
This would be the SEC and the Holiday Bowl.
Pretty confident?
Yes.
You're sounding pretty confident.
I feel pretty confident. Final.
He was confident. That's a big double. Yeah, so the Sugar Bowl is SEC Big 12. Holiday Bowl is ACC Pac-12. Citrus Bowl is ACC or SEC Big 10, as is the Music City Bowl. Okay. So it's 6-2, and we're going to move into the next set of niches with Harry Potter. Hive Mind, here's your question. I've been wanting to ask this Harry Potter question for so long, and I finally got to. The four dragons in the first trial of the Triwizard Tournament were the Hungarian Horntail, Swedish Short Snout, Chinese Fireball, and what other species?
Those are the three I know.
Me too.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to be the Swedish Short Snout, and that would be the obvious one.
Eli, any chance you can pull us out?
No, I don't have it.
Hang on.
Fuck, I remember what Norbert was, but Norbert...
Is it like the Burmese something? No.
What would you say it would be?
No idea.
There wasn't a Norwegian Ridgeback, right?
Yeah, that might be it.
Well, that's Norbert. Remember in the first one they hatch him?
Yeah.
I don't think there is a Norwegian Ridgeback. Eli, what were you thinking goes with Burmese?
I don't know where that came from.
This is a fantastic one.
I think it's
I would just go with Norwegian.
All right. Norwegian Ridgeback, final answer.
Fuck.
I feel like it's from Switzerland, like the Swiss something.
The Swiss. What about the Romanian?
Wait, that sounds right.
Well, I know like they like Ron's brother trains dragons in Romania.
That's true.
The Romanian. Humpback. I don't know.
Romanian Red Devils. Final.
Sean was kind of honestly color wise. It's the common Welsh green.
Never would have come up.
I would have never gone there.
Yeah, it's the one Fleur gets.
I was gonna say, who gets that one?
Fleur gets it. All right, Indy 500 to make it a 2-point game. All of a sudden, here it is. Who is the only Brazilian woman to have participated in a 500, making four straight starts between 2010 and 2013?
This would be. No, she's
got lunch tomorrow.
Wait, no, she's Swiss. Crap. Brazilian woman. Shoot. Why am I spacing on this? It's not her. Oh, no. It is. Oh. Well, I'm really going to kick myself over this one. Shoot. Simona Di Silvestro, final answer.
Gotta be Amanda Nunes. Brazilian sportswoman. Amanda Nunes, final answer.
This is Ana Beatriz Figueiredo. So, I didn't actually anticipate the nations would be quite so difficult tonight, but we went 1-for-4. Halfway point of the game. Next category is NFL champs. It is 6-2, and Hive Mind have their lifelines available. NFL champs. This is about pre-Super Bowl NFL champions. Hive Mind, do you want a double?
No.
Okay, here's your question. What current NFC team won two championships while playing in Chicago in 1925 and 1947?
Fuck, we should have doubled the Cardinals. Arizona Cardinals, final answer.
Correct.
Damn.
All right. Priapism, here's yours. What current NFC team won a championship while playing in Cleveland in 1945?
Was it the wasn't the Ravens, was it?
They're in the AFC.
Oh, fuck. Never mind. I'm going to go Hide.
Wow, I don't know this one. Is it the Rams, I want to say?
What about the Commanders?
No, I don't think it's them.
Broncos.
Or the Lions? Before they moved to Detroit? Cleveland to Detroit's a logical move.
Maybe.
I want to guess Lions, but I don't know.
I'd go with your first one. I feel like there was some like really odd shifting.
What are we saying, Rams or Lions?
Rams.
Rams.
Correct. Ooh. Holly Ooh. Is the team moral compass there.
To get the good point. Job, Holly. I was ready to say Lions.
Just feel like the – I don't know. I just feel like the Lions – did they change at all?
No, I don't think so.
All right, another round of NBA sharpshooters. No one, or actually, yeah, Hive Mind, you want a double?
No.
All right. It's going to be career paths of past three-point contest champions. Hive Mind, this is for you. Name the 2013-2014 three-point contest champ based on his career path.
Austin, unless you're like pretty sure, if you come up with a name, I think we should phone a friend.
I think we should phone a friend.
All right. Steven in the game? Yes, he is. Okay. So we're just going to wait a little bit. It would have been a spur when he won it. That's back when they were like, they were a champion during that time, I think. Does anybody come to mind?
I have one name, but I think he's still playing.
Only player I know. Yeah, I mean, okay, no, this guy looks like he's done. And he like went back to the Spurs. Yeah, so I think he's probably most well known for being a Spur. Yeah, we're going to phone a friend, Steven.
All right, Steven, once you start talking, you have 30 seconds.
I think this is Marco Bellinelli.
All right. Yeah, we're going to final answer that name. I'm not going to give a shit.
It is Marco Bellinelli.
Is he Italian?
Yeah. So you bring the lead up to 5. And Priapism, this is yours. Name the 2010-2011 three-point contest champ based on his career path.
Oh, played for the Pacers?
Did you watch when you were like 4?
Wrong test Pacers.
I have a guess here, but it's someone who was not a shooter. Got traded to the Suns post brawl. No, then it doesn't make sense. Miami Heat. Oh shoot. Oh, James Jones. James Jones. It's James Jones. It's James Jones. James Jones. Final answer.
It is James Jones.
Is he one of LeBron's boys?
He is one of LeBron's boys.
Yeah.
He made the finals
and end of that career looking nice.
Yeah, I think he won 3 titles. Steven, I saw the Jason Capone ones. I was like, I can't ask about that. He's in like the Greek League or something, like a man like owns the team, coaches the team. Okay, movie tropes is our next category.
We're gonna go ahead and hit the double.
That makes sense. Okay, so you're up 4. That would make it a 6-point game with 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, could I sit here if you get this right? Here's your question. What is the term for the plot device in which a seemingly unsolvable situation is abruptly resolved by an unexpected or unlikely occurrence?
Zoe.
Wait, you got what do you think it is, Yoda?
Is it Deus Ex Machina?
Deus Ex Machina, yeah. There's another thing it could be.
It won't be that.
Yeah.
I feel like it's the obvious answer.
Yeah. We're going to go with Deus Ex Machina, final answer.
Is correct. So I had some questions that you didn't double a couple of categories, but paid off in the end. And Priapism, this is your question. What is the informal name for an object or device in a film that serves no purpose other than to drive the plot of the movie, with one of the most famous examples being the briefcase in Pulp Fiction?
Wow, now I can't stop thinking of the Pulp Fiction episode of Community.
Oh, it's so good.
Crap. I don't know the answer.
John, do
you have any idea? Gonna do
Samoan. Not our night, boys.
No, definitely not.
The only thing that's coming to mind is fomite, but that's just because it's an object.
No idea.
Okay, pass.
Okay.
Is it a Spence? Is it a MacGuffin?
Yep.
Okay, final.
Spencer's being unusually reserved with his answers, and it's making me realize that maybe Eli would actually score a lot of points if Spencer wasn't on the team. It's just an observation. Okay. Next, we have a fan favorite category, the War of Northern Aggression.
Just riding the hot hand. Eli and Austin are putting in work the last two games, so I'm taking a back seat.
So, Hive Mind, this is your question. These are both about battles that are called different things by the were called different things by the North and the South. The Battle of Pittsburgh Landing was another name for what major battle that occurred in Tennessee?
Eli, I think it's time for your age-old answer every time we get a Civil War one.
Well, Bull Run?
Yeah.
Is that it?
I have no idea, but I think
Bull Run was in one of the Carolinas. Am I wrong?
I don't know, but every time it's like, you know, it could be like something about the revolution. You know, I'd be like, is that Bull Run?
I got no idea.
Lexington and Concord. I think Bull Run's, unless, oh shit. You know what? We'll throw a second one out there since the game's over. Could this be Antietam or Antietam? Antium? I think it's Antietam.
That sounds better.
All right, we're going to go with Antietam, final answer.
Bull Run. Final.
This is Shiloh, but Bull Run is in Virginia, but it does have an alternate name. The South called it the Battle of Manassas. There was a great Encyclopedia Brown about a sword allegedly belonged to Stonewall Jackson after the Battle of Bull Run, but we won't get into that.
Very forward thinking by the South back then to name them all different things to make it harder to track so we couldn't pinpoint all their big L's as easily.
The Battle of Sharpsburg was another name for what major Civil War battle that occurred in Maryland?
Bull Run.
I don't know. The Battle of Annapolis.
Final.
Could this be Antietam?
That's a good guess.
I know. I don't think it's even called like a battle. They just call it like Antietam or something like that. I don't know if I'm saying it right, but yeah, we're going to go with Antietam. Final answer. Hell yeah. That's
huge.
Yeah, I don't know if I'm saying that right.
Yeah, you are. It came around eventually. All right. We'll finish it out with regional chain restaurants. This Kentucky-based chain is known for fast casual Italian food such as pasta, as well as their breadsticks and Submarino's sandwiches.
Should have saved our phone a friend for Cam.
He wouldn't know this.
He wouldn't know. He doesn't know jack shit.
He doesn't know anything.
I told you, my teammates are killing it. Kentucky fried Italian.
No. We can get it.
The only one I like, I'm kind of thinking it could be CC's.
No.
All right, yeah, it's your turn to dismiss my answers with disgust. Yeah, go for it, Eli. Whatever you want to do.
CC's doesn't have subs.
fucking no.
Eli apparently is very well versed on the CC's menu.
I'm probably the number one fan. I don't know.
Only fan.
Kentucky Carl based.
Carl Jr.'s.
No! Oh my god! Worse. God damn. No, we're gonna go with
CC's
final answer.
So, the only fast food Italian place I know of is Fazoli's.
It's better than my guess.
Which when I told people, but I didn't think it was from Kentucky. I think it's from Ohio, actually. I remember telling, but people didn't believe me that it was real when I told them about it in college.
Sounds like that's our answer.
Okay, Fazoli's final answer.
It's real. And you're telling me about it right now. I've never
heard of this. I love Fazoli's.
There was one. I'm sorry, you have 5 points. I missed one at some point. There was one here in Atlanta, like where I grew up when I was really little. It closed when I was like 7. We were devastated because their breadsticks were amazing.
Oh, great. I once watched a guy have a full meltdown because he couldn't get a meatball sandwich there. It was incredible.
I want everyone to know that Qualls guessed Quiznos on that one. All right, here's the last question of the night. This Miami-based chain is known for specializing in Latin Caribbean cuisine, particularly its marinated grilled chicken, often served with sides such as cheesy yuca bites or plantains.
Don't know.
I vote. I have no idea, and I vote we pass, so we end on a make.
Pass.
And on a make.
I won't even buzz you. You're just abstaining. So, Hive Mind, it's your turn.
Do we have any idea?
No idea.
Nope.
Never. We're never gonna get that.
Yeah, this is Long John Silver's final answer.
This is this company like expanded like crazy like around like 2015 or 16 and like into a bunch of major cities like New York and Chicago and stuff, and they all closed like within a year, everyone but Miami. This is Pollo Tropical.
Never heard of it.
It was good. They had one here for like literally 1 year, and then they closed all their locations outside of Miami. All right, so that'll end us tonight. 12-5 Hive Mind. Not Priapism's night like they said, but undoubtedly they'll be back. They literally will be this week. Wait, don't blow it. I'm going to put all of my Ocho bucks on a Priapism win because they seem to win one, lose one this season, like pretty much on schedule. Hive Mind play 7-0, lick my claws next week, Spencer. And then Priapism
just play in time for
next week, but they also play don't blow it this week. So thanks for playing, guys.
We're the streakiest team of all time. We just put three together. It's inevitable.